Gold prices open up 2022, actually nudging higher, getting north of 1830 for only the second time in a long time, and then did an abrupt 180 and traded down most of the rest of the session, down about 27 bucks today, but did remain above 1800, that key threshold that we've been watching over the last, call it, since just prior to Christmas break. We did see a pop above 1800, and we've stayed there pretty consistently, but over the last month, month and a half, it has been a struggle for gold to stay above that 1800 level. It has been a selling point. We've seen it reach that level several times, only to reverse. At this point, it all becomes contingent on the dollar, which remains on its highs, and how the markets will react to this week's data. We, later on this week, we have the unemployment report in the U.S. We also have the December FOMC minutes, both of which could be big market movers if the dollar reacts one way or the other. Gold prices right now remain very contingent on what happens with the dollar and what happens with Fed policy, and we should get some clarity after this week's data. Now, what does this all mean for volatility? Well, if you check out that CVOL index over at cmegroup.com, you will notice that volatility has been kind of in a tailspin lower, despite the fact that we've seen the dollar remain elevated and we've seen gold prices moving higher amid that higher dollar, albeit today we didn't see that. So ultimately, I think the market right now coiling and waiting for some information. Typically ahead of a big event, we do see volatility bid. That hasn't been the case here. We've seen volatility actually remain pretty much subdued. We've seen a few moments of higher volatility over the last 2 to 3 weeks, but we haven't seen a consistent bid higher. At this point, it's gonna probably wait until we get this data, wait and see what happens to the dollar, wait and see how the market reacts. And then if gold plummets to new lows, it's likely that we'll probably see volatility continue lower. If we see it elevate to new highs, kind of going against the trend, that could be when we see volatility going higher, but we have not seen that as of yet. Volatility, again, lower today. Lastly, let's look at positioning. What are the speculators doing? Well, we didn't get a CFTC report last week because of the holiday, but likely heading into year end, speculators are likely either covering some of those open positions, looking to maybe get flat ahead of the year-end move and maybe reinitiate after we get some of this data this week, which would most likely be if it's very strong data or if we get a very hawkish minutes report, likely would be to see them continue to exit those longs, something we've seen them doing for the last several months. At this point, speculators remain net long, but a lot less long than they were a few months ago. So gold prices opening up the year, it looks like to be a bullish opening, only to reverse, heading down about 27 bucks, but remain north of that key 1800 level ahead of FOMC minutes and the unemployment report.